So her friend now study policy reforms, police reform, okay? So police reform, so now our topic it is. So first introduction, the primary role of police forces is to uphold and enforce. The primary role of police, what? To uphold and enforce laws, investigate crimes, and ensure safety for people in the country. And under the constitution, police is a subject governed by states. There has been almost 30 years debate on policing and reform in India. Need for police reform, if India is to achieve its status as a great power, it is absolutely essential that police is restructured and modernized. If India is to achieve its status of as a great power, it is absolutely essential that police is restructured and modernized. Without the police ensuring good law and order in the country, the other services would find it difficult to operate. To transform the colonial police structure of the country into a progressive modern force sensitive to the democratic aspirations of the people, to eliminate the undue political interference, the police of today are victims of politicization as well as criminalization. To instill the confidence of the people in the institutions of police by making police more people friendly, to security, the security of the society and the welfare of the people is dependent on the efficiency of the police. Okay, Supreme Court, the court's directions on DGP appointment. The Supreme Court order all states and union territories is to not appoint any police officer as acting Director General of Police DGP. Okay, the court directed all the states to send names of senior police officers of the UPSC for being considered as probable candidates to be appointed as DGP. The UPSC will prepare a list of three most suitable officers, and the states will be free to appoint one of them as police chief. Endeavor should be made that a person who had been selected and appointed as DGP, has a reasonable period of service left. However, the extended term beyond the date of annuation should be a responsible period. This will put an end to favoritism and political influence in DGP level appointment. Madras High Court ruling on police weekly off. The Madras High Court has said that the state government should contemplate. Madras High Court ki bolche je Madras High Court has said that the state government should contemplate giving policemen a day off in a week like other government officials in order to spend time with their families. The court suggested to introduce an 8-hour 3 shift system for police personnel. It will help them rejuvenate themselves and relieve them from stress. Policemen were forced to work round the clock, sometimes without any holiday. This would not only affect the police but also their families. The court further noted that a conducive atmosphere should be created for the policemen, as it would help keep the morale high in the interest of the society. The court further noted that a conducive atmosphere should be created for the policemen, as it would help keep the morale high in the interest of the society. Which concerns and challenges. Okay, Justice Thomas Committee 2010 expressed its dismay over the total indifference to the issue of reforms in the functioning Apple is being exhibited by the states, though offered by the government to make the concept of smart police a reality. Officers in the field of are transferred around the year. The complaints authorities are generally dysfunctional. Crime, terrorism, and external threats take a huge toll on economic growth, and that this cost India 9% of its GDP. China lose only 4%, Japan 3%. More policemen die in the performance of their duties every year in the country than in all Europe. Police face shortage of manpower, has poor infrastructure, and has no functional autonomy. The internal structure, the internal security problem, the Maoist insurgency, Kashmir situation, Northeast separatist movements, terrorist threats, etc. Lack of coordination within the police departments, the long working hours, as well as the isolation of police efforts from the public. There are instances of policemen living in subhuman conditions. For an average policeman, there is lack of knowledge about Indian Penal Code and Code of Criminal Procedure. He do not get a chance to develop and refresh his professional skills in service. Way forward. So the police force need to be freed from the stranglehold of the executive and given functional autonomy to ensure and enforce the rule of law. Implementing Supreme Court's directions in progressing a case that police must be service-oriented for the citizens in a manner which is efficient, scientific, and consistent with human dignity. It is high time that government consider bringing police in the concurrent list of the Constitution. Clear separation of law and order and crime function of the police need to fill up the huge vacancies in the police and upgrade their infrastructure in terms of housing, air, transport, communications, and forensics. Okay, police should be a smart police. Okay, a police which should be strict and selective, sensitive, modern and mobile, alert and accountable, reliable, and responsible, takes savvy and trained. Okay, the police must get its due and most of the must be enabled to perform its mandated functions, providing proper training to the constables, functioning to the constables, and inculcating in them a sense of confidence and discipline. Evidence-based policing is gaining credibility day by day. Indian police force must be exposed to it. Second, DRC recommended that the government should declare certain crimes as federal and ensure their investigation of to a central agency. Police need to have the operational freedom to carry out their responsibilities professionally and satisfaction, working condition, well-being, and accountable for poor performance or misuse of power. What we need today is people's police. Okay, our strength and influence abroad being with the steps we take at home. Our policemakers.